Okay, hello everyone and welcome to a new CRPL programming tutorial series where I will explain to you how to make custom units in CRPL. And in this first episode we will be creating a custom emitter, or rather a custom skip that will change an emitter so that the amount of creeper produced is the equal to the amount of your units. So let me show how it works. So right now it says 8. So if I build a new unit, you can see that while it is building, it is still 8. So let me speed the game up a little bit. It's almost done. And you see the moment it is finished, it starts producing 9 creeper instead. So this is like a basic script with which we will start today. And one last thing before we dive in, no requirements are required. I mean, no knowledge of programming or any other thing like that is required. So if you've never made a script before or anything like that, you can still watch this tutorial and learn from it just fine. So let's start by creating a new map. Let's call it new tutorial and go into it. And just like before, I like to create just a void between so that the creeper here will not overflow my base and I don't have to deal with it. So let's save this thing and let's get to it. So first we need to put the emitter down, so just be to build it. And what I like to do, you have two options with which you can do it. You can either make a, this is the CRPL core that we will be using. You can either make a script that will act like an emitter. That means it will be producing the creeper itself and it will display the text and so on. Or you can make a core that will, you can make a script in a CRPL core that will just change the amount of an existing emitter. Now I like the second method more because you don't have to deal with the text, you don't have to deal with the image and so on and so forth. And if you see, the image is actually animated, so it would be it's not impossible to animate images in scripts, of course, but you get the animation for free if you use a real emitter and just a script next to it that will just change the amount. So let's edit the map once more and finally let's get to the real question here. How to program this script here so that it changes the amount of creeper that this emitter produces? Well, for that we use this PRPL core. You can see I already built one, but it doesn't do anything yet. It just sits there. So I need to actually create a script first and then put the script into the core. So let's make our new script. It will be called amount setter, for example, because it sets the amount of the creeper. Create, and now we hit edit. Now it opens the script for me in Notepad++, and I can start editing it. Now, if you try this right now and it doesn't work, then you need to set up the text editor properly. Now I will do that at the end of the video, but for now let's just put the code in. So there are several things we need to do. First, we need to find out how many player units are there, currently 0. So let's just build some units so that we can, hang on, can I make the orbit from here? No, it doesn't look like it. So let me, okay, I have to close this. Okay, let me build the command base and let me build some editors, I mean collectors, okay. Just a few. Cool. So now we have 5 player units. So how to check how many units are there? Well, what you want to do is go here. I will put a link to this site in the description. And here you have a list. Oh, my bad. This is for particle thing. This is for creeper world. Yes. So here you have a list of all the functions that you can use in your core. However, I will get into this more in the second episode. For now, I will use a little bit of cheating, and I will copy the code from what I prepared before. Now, don't worry, I will go over what to put here in the next episode more. But for now, let's see that it works. So if I go script compile all, you can see that the script compiled fine. And the reason why I'm skipping this is because this is just too much complicated for new programmers that have never used any programming before, that I couldn't explain it now. It would take me like half an hour, so that's why I'm leaving it for another episode. But as I said, for now, let's see that it works. So it's important after editing your script to hit the compile button. It says compiled. Also, you can close this. Now you can see still nothing happens. That is because you still need to add the script into this core. So you can have any amount of cores on the map. You can just build like if I close this. Now this is like this. You can build how many you want. And each core can have how many scripts it wants. Again, you can go into scripts and you can create how many scripts you want. Each can do something differently. I mean something different. And then each core can have like any amount of scripts that you wish. But for now, we will have just one core with one script. But don't forget to actually add the script into the core like this. So now this core should be executing the code which is in the script that we created previously. So let me delete these so that they don't confuse us, as well as delete this because we don't need it. And now if we unpause it, it should start working. So you can see amount 5. You can also see that the core disappeared, and it should be working now. So let me just quickly build a blaster here. I mean a cannon. So let's speed it up. I mean, this is the same as you saw at the start of the video. So it goes from 5 to 6. Now there are some problems with it. For example, if you move the blaster, it actually goes back to 5. Because when the blaster is flying through the air, the method I use in this script, which is namely get units in range, doesn't register units which are flying through the air, which is a little bit unfortunate because maybe you want to detect this cannon as well for the unit count, but the code would be a lot more complicated, and I wanted to make it simple even for this first tutorial, because now at the end I want to do two more things, and that is explain this code at least a little bit, what each thing does, and in the next episode we will be taking an in-depth look, and I will be explaining each command exactly how it works, how the code execution functions, how the values are put and taken from the stack, and so on. So for now, let's just go over it line by line. So the first thing here is something that is called like a script parameter or something like that. I don't know exactly how it's called. So this is the emitter. So you can still edit the interval just like you would on a normal emitter. Yes. And then if you see the core, which is now has an invisible image, but you can still see it. When you click on the skip, you see the coefficient here, which is the same from here. Now what this does is you can actually change it here in the editor. So you can have multiple emitters like this with the same core, but with the different coefficient here. And what that will do is it will, if I unpause, it will now produce 1.5 creeper per each unit. So since I have 6 units, it creates 9, but if I delete one, it should do 7.5. So you see that this is useful. Maybe you want to have different emitters, so let me just show that. Again, let me build another emitter and another script under it. Again, edit map, I need to add this to the script and let's leave it at one for this one. Close. And then you can see that this creates one creeper per unit, which is 5 because I have 5 units. And this creates 1.5 creeper per unit. And since I have 5 units, that's 7.5. And you see that I just need one script. It is the same script, just the different parameter here. So that's what this is for. So this is quite useful. Even for balancing, because you can just change it on the map. You don't even have to Alt-Tab and then compile and so on. So what's next? Yes, this is very useful. So let me change this so you can see. Apply and close. Yes, as I said, if you change the script, you need to hit the compile button, which I don't think I have. Yes. Now I can see some print. Now what this does? You can see this command here, trace, later on, which will print some value here into this window. And this command just say that I want to show the trace log. This window is called the trace log, and I want to show it. And this I want to clear previous messages. So it will always display what these are called variables. So I just want to see what is in those variables. And this second variable is the number of units. So even without the amount, I can see that the number of variables here. This is good when you are making the script. Maybe it isn't working, so you put just trace half the way through and you see whether or not even the unit count is being counted, because maybe it's not working and you don't know if the unit count is getting counted wrong or the amount isn't being set properly. Now, if you can only see that the amount is not being set properly, you don't know where the problem is. But if you can print the number of units and you see that the number of units is fine, you know that the problem is in setting the amount. So now that you have, now let me go over the rest, which will be really quick. So first you can see here, this will make the core invisible, undestroyable by nullifiers and so on, which uses the set unit attribute. Again, more on that later, but for now you can see that it sets different parameters for the unit, such as that you don't need to destroy this in order to win the game. And it doesn't create a power zone, again, doesn't take map space. Now that's important, because otherwise I couldn't build this blaster here. So these are just some parameters for the core itself. And again, so that it doesn't show an image. Next, we want to find the emitter. Again, remember this core here just changes the amount of the emitter. That's like one position above it. So I first need to find the emitter, which is doing this get unit add. Now this is arithmetic in CRPL. Again, more on that in this video. For now, this will get the Y position, but one on top. Again, sorry for the bad explanation, but this video will be too long already. So wait for the second episode for more detail on this. And then it finds the emitter and saves it to this variable. Again, I just print it so that I know what happens there. This is just for debugging. It doesn't change the behavior. And next, it counts the unit. In fact, this finds all the units and puts the count on the top of the stack. So I just take the count and leave the rest there, which is not the best thing to do. But it's just a first script, so it's not that bad. So again, this just finds all player units, saves it, and then finally what I need to do is set the amount of creeper created. Now this is done via this command, set script var, and how this works is a little bit complicated. Again, if you just Google set script var here, you can open a new tab and you can see that it says you can also set variables of built-in units like emitters, and there are some example. If you go into emitter, you see, now this is whatever, yes, production amount, and it says the amount of creeper multiplied by 1,000,000. Now, why is it multiplied by a million? Well, it's because the creeper is actually stored as an integer, which is the value multiplied by a million. Well, I guess that's just a detail. But if you want to set the amount of creeper in an emitter that an emitter produces like this, you need to multiply the amount by a million. And also don't forget to multiply it by the coefficient, which is why the coefficient is here. And it is just set the amount. So I've that's it for today. I mean, when it comes to this script, again, let's get rid of the trace log and just hide it. Now if I compile, close and unpause, yeah, it goes away. And last thing I promised is if this edit button doesn't work for you, which is quite possible, I will show you how to set up your text editor. So in order to do that, just download Notepad++. Now, if you don't want to use Notepad++, you can just use... Oh no, this is not it. Yeah, just put Notepad++ download into Google. It will be the first link. I will put the link in the description again. So you just download and install it. Now, once it's done, you still need to set either this text editor or any other text editor that you want to use as the default text editor for the files with the CRPL extension. Now the best way to do it is just create a... Okay, maybe not here. maybe I'll edit it out somehow. Yeah, just create any file anywhere with the CRPL extension, which can be just, the name doesn't matter. Just make sure it has the .crpl extension. That does the important part. Now, if you are using Windows, just right click it, go into properties, and then open Swift. You can then change it to Notepad++ here. You click OK, apply OK. And now when you go back here and you click edit, it should open in Notepad++. Now one last thing, how to do the syntax coloring like this, so you see variables in blue and arithmetic commands in red and so on, and numbers in dark blue and so forth. Now to do this, you go into here. Again, link will be in the description. There is a pinned post in the in the coder's corner somewhere, which is, you can even use Sublime instead of Notepad++, but I haven't used it, so I don't know how that works. Now this is syntax highlighter, forget it, I don't want that, I want for Notepad++, where is it? Is this it? What is this? Also, I mean, why are there two files? I don't understand. Okay, let's try this one. I mean, you can, let's save it here. Just download this XML and then go into language, define your language. Now you can see I have CRPL already here, but you will just click import. Then you will locate where it was downloaded. If I can remember even myself, I think I downloaded here. Into other, I believe, yes. So you just open it. Yes, you just click open here. I will not click open because I have it already imported, and then it would be there twice and it would cause problems. But after you click import, it should work. You just close it and then you should see it in this list. So you just select it, and next time you reset the Notepad++, it should work automatically. So that's it for this tutorial. I hope it wasn't too terrible. And thanks for watching, and see you next time. Bye.